I've used this technique a couple of times and I thought I would share it so everybody can give it a try. Look at that background. It's pretty cool. And once we start laying down the resin, it's gonna pop. I'm working on a DaVinci Birch panel that I've spray painted black with Rustoleum paint. It's a gloss black, and now I'm putting some Liquitex acrylic ink. This is their iridescent, their metallics, and this is silver. I'm out, it's a really warm sunny day here, and I'm putting down with a foam brush. I'm really quickly working. So I'm just laying down an area with this silver, and then I hit it with some 91% alcohol. It's not a fine mist, it's kind of a rough mist, and you just spritz that on top, and you can see the effect that that alcohol hitting the acrylic ink gives you. It's kind of fun. And you got to work fast. It's really important to do this. I like to do it on a bright sunny day because I find that having the bright sunshine helps for the alcohol to evaporate very quickly. And that's what helps to get this technique working really well. So now I'm getting some of, again, this is all the Liquitex acrylic ink. This is their copper. And again, it's an iridescent, and these are acrylic inks. So when you hit it with the 91% alcohol, that's what creates that. It's almost like an orange peel pattern that you get in that ink. Let's zoom in here and get you guys a close-up look. I enjoy using the Liquitex acrylic inks for a couple of reasons. I know that the color is not going to fade on me. They're high quality pigments, and some of, you know, you can use alcohol inks. A lot of people use alcohol inks with resin, but I prefer to use this in a case of like this type of situation. I have no fear that the ink is going to fade with time. That's always a potential. So they're going to hold up really well. I'm shaking up a bottle of the brass, and it's another one of their iridescent inks. They have, I don't even know, maybe 18, 20 different shades of acrylic inks that they have in the Liquitex line. So I'm, again, just working with that foam brush. I haven't dampened the brush. I'm just sticking it right into that ink and working around. It's really important to do small areas because, again, the sunshine today, the warmer temperatures will make that ink dry out very quickly, and you want it to be wet when you hit it with that alcohol. So work in small patches. I, you know, felt like this was a good type of a situation to do this technique because I knew I could blend it over top in layers and still make it work out really well. I'm just going to finish that up. Also, it works well, I find, if I'm doing it on top of a glossy spray paint. So the spray paint, again, that I used, it's Rustoleum. It's their 2x coverage, and this is the gloss black. So it's a really nice shiny surface. When I spray paint this, I give it, oh, I think I let it dry so that I knew it was going to be completely hard. I let it dry for probably a week. I had, again, a nice day and ran outside and did some spray painting to prep some boards. I forgot to mention that the sides of my panel are taped off, so having the ink go over the edge is not a problem. They'll be clean when I'm done.
All right, it has been several days and I am in the studio. So this is the effect that I got from that technique, and it's done with metallics. So, you know, sorry, there's going to be shine on here like that, but it's pretty cool. I like the effect. And again, this is just to get a base layer because they're, you know, it's going to get built up. Other things are going to happen on top of this. Not really sure what direction I'm going with it, but I'm going to play around with it, and I'm going to be drawing in and making it look hopefully like river rocks. So let's get going.
Okay, so I've got my handy dandy uni Posca marker, black. And these are water-based markers. They do not hold up well as far as cleaning and stuff like that. So when I use a Posca marker, I always do a clear coat of resin over top. So you can see I'm just, you know, randomly drawing a circle and then filling in blindly with the black.
Here's a little progress shot. So it's very, meditative working on this, but I'm liking the way it's going. Making my pebbles, selecting how I do this process. I just thought I'd give you a little peek.
And I've got another bright sunny day, so I brought it outside to give you a real good look at how that Posca marker worked. It's really nice and blocks out that background. And we'll be using Total Boat resin, their tabletop epoxy. I find that it's a really nice thick resin. It's easy on releasing any bubbles. And you can see that I've got a tape dam around this piece that's going to hold all the resin on top of the piece while I'm working. My sides are also taped off. And I'm randomly placing glass filler beads from the dollar store, flat side down. It's the next day, and I have already taken this outside and sanded down the edges and put on new tape. And I'm adding another 20 ounces of the Total Boat resin. I'm just filling it in all between the gaps, making sure I don't have any empty zones. And I'm placing a few more of those beads. This is going to give it more of a layered look. Some of the beads are going to sit a little bit higher up because they've got that resin layer that we first poured down. So it just builds the depth on here. And now we're just pulling off that tape dam. I've waited about 45 minutes and let the resin set up on top. So that's going to hold it in place. And I'm going to look for any specks of dust and use a popsicle stick to make sure that I've got it filling in any of the areas on the edge, and then using my torch to roll it over.
All right. I just took the dust cover off and things are looking mighty fine. Check out that edge. That's pretty cool looking. I'm happy with that. The surface looks, look at that shine. Can you see the reflection of the wall in the background? Hell, that's pretty sweet. Look at that. All right, so now I'm going to warm up the tape with my heat gun and get that off of there. And we'll take her outside. It's a sunny day. We'll get a good look at what happened here, okay?
I'll tell you what, I don't know where I would be without my Wagner heat gun. I just love my Wagner heat gun. Anyway, don't put your heat gun in one spot for too long. You just want to warm it up slightly. It's really important to do this the very next day because the resin has not cured really strong. So if you just warm it up a touch, that tape pulls right off, and if you've done a good job laying it down, you've got a beautiful seal. Look at this thing outside in the sunlight. It is glorious. The Liquitex acrylic inks are shiny and bright. It looks like metal laying down there. That detail from the effect with the alcohol spritzed on while it's wet, being out in the sunshine, it really gives a fun look. So try that out. See if you guys can't figure out where you might be able to use it in your next resin artwork piece. Don't forget to subscribe here on Moonkusser Art. And thanks so much for watching. We'll see you here again next time.